This kit comes with carbon polyolefin, conductive textile, conductive thread, gaff tape, and fusible fabric. You will also need a ruler, a pencil or pen, tape, scissors, an iron, and a piece of cloth. Notice that one of the fusible fabric sides is shiny. Place this fabric in a portrait position with the shiny side down. Now mark a half an inch off from the bottom edge. Continue to make marks every half an inch until the other bottom edge, so that you have 5 segments separated by 4 marks. Repeat the same process towards the top edge. Take a ruler and draw a line from each one of the top marks to the corresponding bottom mark to create a straight line. Now count 3 lines and cut the fabric in 2 so that there is a section with 3 segments and one with 2. At this point, you should plug in your iron on the medium to high setting so that it has time to heat up. With the shiny side up, fold the 3-segment piece of fusible fabric so that the first segment folds over the second, and then those 2 segments fold over the third. This ensures that all of the adhesive is on the inside of the fabric. You should not be able to see any of the shiny side anymore. With the fabric folded, use the piece of cloth to cover the fabric in order to protect it from burning while you iron the cloth and, in effect, the fabric underneath it. You should only have to iron for a couple of seconds for the adhesive to activate. The adhesive will melt and the fabric should now stick together so that it appears as one thicker segment. Take the 2 pieces of conductive textile, which appear golden on one side and white on the other, and place them golden side up on the piece of fusible fabric that you just folded. Ensure that the textiles line up with the fabric on each edge with a space between the textiles. These 2 textiles should not be touching. Once again, cover the fabric and textiles with a piece of cloth and iron over it for a few seconds until the textiles are attached to the fabric. This combination will serve as the sensor's base. For now, place the base to the side. Now take the 2-segment piece of fusible fabric which we cut off earlier and cut it in half to separate the 2 segments into single segments. One of the segments can be put off to the side. It is an extra piece provided to you in case you make a mistake during this step. Place the remaining segment of fabric in a landscape position and mark it from one edge at each of these measurement points, 2 inches, 1 inch, and 3 inches. Fold the fabric segment at the 3-inch mark so that the end of the fabric touches the 2-inch mark. Now fold that same piece again on top of itself to create a square that's about half an inch. Next, we will cut out a triangle from the small square that we just folded. Start close to each corner and cut diagonally until a small triangle is cut out. Now follow the same process on the other side of the fabric segment. Fold the fabric segment at the 1-inch mark so that the end of the fabric touches the 2-inch mark. Now fold that same piece again on top of itself to create a square that's about half an inch. Cut out another triangle from this square. When unfolded, the fabric should have a diamond pattern. This pattern is key to the sensor's quality and performance. Take the fabric and cut off half of the first diamond. We will not need the piece we just cut off. Place the fabric shiny side down onto one edge of the base. Cover the base with the fusible fabric on top with a piece of cloth and once again iron it to activate the adhesive. After a few seconds, depending on your iron type and setting, check to make sure that the fabric is attached to the base. Sometimes you may need to iron again to ensure that the fabric is fully attached to the base. Cut 2 pieces of tape, about 1/4 inch each. You can use the edge of the table or your hand to hold the pieces of tape while you are working. Next, take the carbon polyolefin and place it next to the base, starting from the edge that has the fusible fabric, not the edge that has only the golden conductive textile. You may need to cut off a bit, usually 1/4 inch or less, so that you can't see any of the fabric. Place the carbon polyolefin on top of the base so that it covers the fabric. Make sure that the golden contacts are visible. Take the conductive thread and place it in the center of the base, going from one edge to the other, starting from about an inch above the fusible fabric. It's okay if the thread runs longer than the bottom edge of the base, but make sure that the beginning of the thread is between the two golden conductive textiles. You want the thread to be as centered as possible. Use the two pieces of tape to hold the thread down to the base. This is temporary. This is how it should look. To prepare the gaff tape, lay it down in front of you, black side down, in landscape position. Now mark 1 inch on each edge, left and right, and use a ruler to draw a straight line between the marks. Cut the tape in two, following the line. Take one of the halves, peel off the back, and place it black side down. Place the base with the thread facing up in the center of the tape, allowing it to stick. You may have to firmly press it down to ensure that the base is attached to the tape. Take the other half of the tape and mark 1/2 inch from the left edge of the tape if it is in a landscape position in front of you. Cut the tape at the mark. Peel off the backing and apply the tape, ensuring that you match the edge of the tape to the edge of the fusible fabric where the golden conductive textile is no longer visible. Use your thumb to slide across the tape to press it down against the base and the tape on the other side. Now use your fingernail or a coin to outline the base on the inside. Cut off any excess tape around the golden conductive textile and the sensor's edges. To remove the thread tail that is sticking out of the bottom end of the sensor, cut off about 1/8 inch of the sensor from the end. Now peel off the tape from the top part of the sensor with the thread attached and cut this off. You can now optionally test the sensor using a multimeter. It doesn't matter which wire, red or black, is on each of the golden conductive textile contacts. As you bend the sensor, the resistance changes. After some use, the sensor may not be as accurate as when you first made it. To fix this, OWL developed a technique that will reset the sensor to original working condition. All you need is a tongue depressor. Just lift up a piece of the gaff tape near the golden contacts and slide the tongue depressor inside the sensor until it hits the bottom of the sensor. Then slide it back out. Gently run your thumb over the sensor to close the gap created by the tongue depressor. Your sensor should now be back to original working condition. Thank you for watching the OWLet Flexi.on tutorial video.